better yet, let's just suppose that for the moment I have V equals 2 cosine T. What is the period of this cosine T? How much time does it take to repeat itself?
A second.
No?
No.
2 pi.
2 pi. Because the cosine function, whatever is in there, needs to go up to 2 pi before it repeats. Not 1, but to 2 pi. So here the period would be 2 pi. What's the period of that?
4 pi.
Is it been scrunched together or stretched out more?
Stretched out more.
No, James was right earlier about the shift.
There's two cycles within.
But cosine 2t will be going twice as fast. So here the period would be pi. It's the 2t makes it go twice as fast. How about the frequency of this bottom case down here? 1 over 2 pi. Frequency is 1 over the period. Period is how much time to repeat once. Frequency is how many repeats per second. So I'll say that again. Period is how many seconds per cycle. Frequency is how many cycles per second. They are exactly inverses of each other. How about up here? What's the frequency?
1 over pi.
Okay, what if that, instead of being a 2, one last case, what if instead of being a 2, it was an omega? First, what would be the period?
2 pi divided by omega over 2 pi.
Almost.
2 pi divided by omega. And then 1 over t.
And then the frequency would be?
Omega over 2 pi.
Okay. So in the case of the motor being plugged into the wall, the frequency is 60 hertz. So to get the omega, I would take the frequency times 2 pi. So in that formula, Li omega, that omega is what's called the angular frequency. It's not the same. There's a relationship between the two. So for the wall socket, the frequency is 60 hertz. The omega would be that times 2 pi. All right, let's do another example.